I am Kira Cass, the best-selling author of the Selection Trilogy, and my two books currently out are The Selection and The Elite. The Selection has been pitched as The Hunger Games meets The Bachelor. There's a lottery, it's in the future, but instead of fighting to the death, they're fighting to become the next princess, so it's a bit more romantic. The story follows a young girl named America as we see her life and her love, her boyfriend, but they're separated by a social system that doesn't let them be together. And he sort of encourages her to put her name in for the selection, and so she does, and of course gets drawn, and then realizes that the prince, who she always thought was a bit stuffy, is not that at all. So it's a love story, a bit of a triangle, with her sort of trying to figure out if she wants to go with something that's very familiar and very safe, or try this new thing that would require a lot of bravery out of her. So. The inspiration behind The Selection came from wondering about the what-ifs in two other stories, Esther from the Bible and Cinderella. Esther, there's this big party going on. The king calls his wife, and she doesn't come to him, and so his friends are all drunk and say, let's have a beauty pageant and get a new queen, get rid of this one. So Esther is one of hundreds, maybe thousands of girls who's brought to the palace, and you know, once you were in, you weren't leaving. Either you were the queen or you were in a harem, which is absolutely horrible. And she wins, she becomes queen, and she ends up saving her people. Beautiful, wonderful things she does. But I always wondered if maybe she liked the boy next door. Like, you know, what if there was someone she loved and she had to let that die? So just curious about her heart. And then Cinderella never asked for a prince. She asked for a night off and a dress. So we assume she's happy because she got her prince, but what if she wasn't? That's a very serious job. What if she didn't want it? So those two things kind of came together in my head, and I knew I wanted to write about this girl who came from a very humble background and would get the attention of a prince, but she wouldn't want it because she was already in love, and she would go through this thing that would show her more of the world than she ever thought she would see, and that thing was the selection. So it all sort of came together, and it took me a while to figure out where to put it, because in my head it read like a fairy tale, but I couldn't find a place in the past that worked, so I said I'd just put it in the future. So a dystopian by fault, but it doesn't really read like one. It reads a bit more like a fairy tale. I don't know. As far as what I like to read, my favorite, I read a lot of contemporary, which is surprising because I don't write it, can't write it. But I love contemporary books, probably my favorite book right now is The Book Thief by Marcus Zusak. Really beautiful. I wish I could write so lyrically. It's beautiful. As far as authors I looked up to, Stephanie Meyer is a huge one. I don't think I would have tried to get published if she hadn't made it sound like it was so easy. She just sounded like she sent out a couple of letters and it was done. It's not that easy, but if she hadn't said it was, I don't think I would have tried. So I owe her a hug if I ever get to meet her. I really like, when I'm not writing, I'm being mommy, and I like being mommy, but I also like hanging out online. A lot of my readers are very young, so they're online too, so I'm always on Twitter and Tumblr and Facebook and YouTube, and that's a lot of fun for me, but it's also, it's work, so I get to work for fun. If I could be one thing, oh my goodness. I almost said cake, but then I would be devoured. I don't want to be cake. I'd be a pinwheel. They have a good life. It's fun to be a pinwheel.